Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. Satellite data continues to enable weather forecasters to look inside and outside of powerful hurricanes. Imagery from NOAA's GOES East satellite, captured September 17th to 20th, shows Hurricane Jose along the U.S. East Coast and Hurricane Maria as it moved through the Leeward Islands, strengthening to a Category 5 hurricane and making landfall in Puerto Rico. Meanwhile, the Global Precipitation Measurement satellite found rain falling inside Maria at a rate of over 6.44 inches per hour in powerful storms that reached above 9.7 miles high. SpaceX's Dragon cargo craft was released from the International Space Station and splashed down in the Pacific Ocean on September 17th. A variety of technological and biological studies returned in Dragon, including an experiment to test strategies for growing new lung tissue and a study designed to help scientists better understand the pathology of Parkinson's disease. On September 22nd, the new Katherine G. Johnson Computational Research Facility was officially opened at Langley Research Center in Hampton, Virginia. Johnson, who is now 99 years old, worked as a human computer at Langley in the 1960s, calculating trajectories for America's first space flights. The new 37,000 square foot state-of-the-art facility will be used for innovative research and development in support of our air mobility and space exploration missions. Our OSIRIS-REx spacecraft used Earth's gravity on September 22nd to slingshot itself onto a path toward the asteroid Bennu. OSIRIS-REx launched September 8, 2016 on an Atlas V rocket. The rocket provided the momentum required to propel the spacecraft forward to Bennu, but it needed help from Earth's gravity to change its orbital plane. OSIRIS-REx is scheduled to arrive at Bennu in late 2018. The Hubble Space Telescope was used to image an asteroid in September 2016, just before it made its closest approach to the Sun. Hubble's crisp images revealed that it was actually not one, but two asteroids of almost the same mass and size, orbiting each other at a distance of 60 miles. A September 21st event at the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum's Stephen F. Udvar-Hazy Center in Chantilly, Virginia, featured two new challenges to engage the public in our future missions. Activities included a challenge to show why 3D printing technology is important to the future of space travel, as well as a challenge with support from the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation to advance the development of aerosol sensor technologies, which can help improve air quality and health in space and on Earth. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at www.nasa.gov.